Now let us continue with our letter. This year we will do 5 letters, that is letter of inquiry, placing order, complaints about products, complaints about basic amenities, and lastly letter to the editor. Now let's start with the letter of inquiry. As the name suggests, letter of inquiry is a letter that is written to inquire about something. For example, asking about some scheme or details about some course. Alright. Now first, let us see the format once again. Alright, this is very important. The format is very important. So let us just see it once again. First, we have the sender's address. Then we write the date. Remember that when you write the date, make sure that it coincides with the question. For example, if the question mentions that you want to join a computer course during your summer vacation. Now, when you write the letter, the date that you mention in the letter should be of the month of May. Next, we have the receiver's address. Here in the first line, we will write the designation of the person we are writing the letter to. For example, the manager, the director. Generally, this is also given in the question. So let me repeat, read the question carefully. In the second line, we will write the name of the institute or company. After that, the rest of the address as mentioned in the question. Next, we have the salutation and subject. After writing this, we divide the body of the letter into 3 paragraphs. In the first paragraph, we give reference to a newspaper where we saw the advertisement, for example, the Times of India, the Hindu, etc. If the name is given in the question, obviously we are going to use that. If it is not given, we will mention in which newspaper we saw the advertisement. We should also mention the date when we saw the advertisement. Alright, suppose you saw the advertisement on 30th April. Alright, so you may be writing the letter on 3rd April or you may be writing the letter on 10th April. Alright, but it should not be 30th December. Alright, the gap between the date of the advertisement and when you are writing the letter should not be vast. Alright, so just try to keep this difference, okay, to the minimum of 10 days or 12 days, not more than that. Now we should also mention or we should also express our keenness in joining the course. The next paragraph or the second paragraph should contain the queries that we would like to be addressed. Alright, it is generally written in a bulleted or in points form. That way it is very neat and clean, and the person who is reading the letter can easily see, alright, what you are writing or what are the queries that you want to it to be addressed. This I will be telling you a little later. In the last paragraph, we conclude the letter again expressing our keenness to join the course as soon as we get the information. We will be mentioning that we have enclosed a self-addressed envelope or an email address. Alright, this is given so that the person that we are writing the letter to can easily revert back to us and give us the information that we are seeking. Alright, lastly, we write the complimentary clause and the sender's name. Moving on, let's see what are the queries that we should write in the second paragraph. Okay, these are first of all duration, that is the time duration of the course. As you will be enrolling in a course, you should be aware about the length of the course. Second, we ask about the timings of the batch. This is important as you need to pick up the timings which suits you. Next, we ask about the fee and the fee structure. Okay, and we also ask about the transportation facilities. Then comes the certification. Here we inquire whether the course we are interested in is certified course or not. It is best to check who or which institute or university has certified the course. Let's move on. Next is the hands-on experience. Now, hands-on experience means knowledge or skill that someone gets from doing something rather than just reading about it or seeing it being done. Alright, more practical than theoretical. Therefore, we should inquire whether the course is theoretical or practical and choose wisely. I think all the students are aware about evaluation. Here too, one should be aware beforehand whether examination will be conducted or not, so that the student can prepare in advance. Last but not the least, the strength of batches. One should be aware about the number of students in a batch. One should remember that these queries will change based on the question. For example, if the question mentions that you are a resident of Delhi, but it also mentions that the institute is in Hyderabad, then you need to inquire about the boarding and lodging facilities, that is the hostel facilities. Alright, so you should be aware that according to the question, these queries will change. Alright, but most of the time it is the same. Okay, so learn these queries, what you need to write in your letter. Now let us take a look at one of the example. Now the question here is, you wish to do a computer course during your summer holidays. You have come across an advertisement where Digital World is offering short-term courses in animation. Write a letter making inquiries. You are Seema or Sameer of 150 Rajnagar, New Delhi. Alright, so first thing we see here, in the question, we know the name of the institute, that is Digital World. We have our sender's address, that is 150 Rajnagar, New Delhi. Then we also have the sender's name, either Seema or Sameer. Now, let's come to the first part. First is a sender's address. Here we have written 150. Alright. No comma at the end. Then next line, Rajnagar. Again no comma. Then New Delhi. Okay. So this we have written. We can also write 150 comma Rajnagar, and in the second line we can write New Delhi. But this way also it is correct. Now again we'll leave one line. Then we will write the date. Very important, we are not going to write the word date. Alright, so here, as I have already mentioned, they have said summer holidays. Alright, so here, summer holidays, we need to inquire way in advance. So here, for example, we have written 22nd April. You can write 1st May, you can write 2nd May. Alright, but before your summer vacations. So here you can write the date, for example 2nd May 2020. Alright. Then again we will leave one line. Then in the receiver's address, first line we will write the designation of the person to whom we are writing to. For example, Digital World is an institute. There will be different departments. Alright. We are not referring to, or we are not talking to the whole Digital World, we are talking to some person. So that person here is the director. Alright, if it is not given, you can write the director, the manager, alright, the assistant manager. Then second line we will write the name of the institute, that is Digital World. Next line here, because the address is not given, alright, so we have created our own South extension. Next line, New Delhi. Alright. After that, again we have left one line. Then, salutation, sir, / madam also we can write. Again we have left one line. Subject, we will write the word subject. We will not write S-U-B. We will write the whole word subject. Then we will put the colons and inquiry regarding short-term course. Alright, simple. What is the subject? What are you asking for? We are making an inquiry regarding short-term course. Alright, so here short term courses in animation. So in the question that was short term courses in animation, so we have written inquiry regarding short term courses. You can also write inquiry regarding animation course. Again, leave a line. Then the first paragraph. This is with reference to the advertisement in the Times of India dated 20th April 2020 regarding the short-term courses being offered by your institution. I am keen to join the course on animation. Okay, so two things we have mentioned here. One is the advertisement that was in the Times of India. We have also written the date 20th April, because here we are writing the letter on 22nd April. So we have written here 20th April. Next thing we have written here is I am keen to join the course on animation. Okay, leave one line. This much is enough. There is no need to write extra here. These two lines are more than enough for this paragraph. Alright. So if you simply learn this paragraph, alright, you will be able to make changes according to the question. Next, leaving one line. Alright. However, before registering, I would like to know a few details regarding the course. Alright, we have come to the second paragraph. We are asking something here. What are we asking? First is the duration of the course and timings. Alright, here again you can divide it into two parts. Duration of the course, next line, second point, you can put the timings. But we have put it here, duration of the course and the timings. Next point we have made, fees and mode of payment. Alright, third point, whether transportation is available or not. Alright, then fourth, is it a certified course? Then fifth point, will we get hands-on experience? Is there an evaluation at the end of the course? And last, what is the strength of the batch? Alright, so this paragraph we have kept for the queries. Alright, simple points are there that you need to write. Then the third paragraph and the last paragraph, I am very keen to join the animation course and would like to register as soon as I have the information. I am enclosing a self-addressed envelope and I am hoping for a quick reply. Alright, so instead of a self-addressed envelope, we can also give our email address. Alright, then I am very keen to join the animation course and would like to register as soon as I have the information. Kindly send the details on my email address xyz@gmail.com. Alright. Then full stop. I am hoping for a quick reply. This way also we can write. Then again we have left a line and we have written at the end, yours truly, and the name that was given in the question, Seema. Alright. So with this we come to the end of this part. Alright. I hope you understood. Go through it once again, and if you have any difficulty, contact me.